When Father Patrick Desbois called me several weeks ago and announced that he would like to bring a group of high church officials to the museum, we immediately said, of course. After all, it was here in the museum in 2005 that Father Desbois first described to the Jewish world the full scope of his undertaking, that is, locating and identifying the graves of Jews murdered by the Germans in Ukraine during the Holocaust. And it was the museum that became the first American venue, and so far the only one, to host the remarkable exhibition that details Father Desbois' work. We immediately said yes because we have always sought a close connection to the Catholic Church. Indeed, John Cardinal O'Connor spoke at the dedication of our museum and forged our connection with the schools of the Archdiocese, stating that it was his desire that every student from every Catholic school visit the museum. And since then, thousands of Catholic school students and their teachers have come to the museum and learned about a painful and difficult history. They have learned about this history because people like Cardinal O'Connor and Father Desbois and Cardinal Vingt-Trois recognize that to become a good man or woman, to become a good citizen, to become a good Catholic, one must learn about and learn from perhaps the darkest moment in human history. And so we welcome this group of distinguished leaders to our museum this afternoon as we continue to carry on our crucial mission. And we welcome them at a particularly painful moment as we try to absorb the still stinging news that a reinstated church leader, Bishop Richard Williamson, has publicly denied a history that any recent graduate of a New York Archdiocese school knows to be true and irrefutable. We welcome our guests knowing that by their visit, they send an undeniable message to all that there is no room for Williamson's message or that of others like him in the hearts and minds of good men and women, of good citizens of the world, of those who want to be part of the human community. We welcome our guests in this most beautiful of settings, under the gaze of the Statue of Liberty, and we are heartened by the meaning of their mission and by their resolve.
Here in New York, in this splendid museum of Jewish heritage, at the tip of Manhattan, we are just a cable length away from Ellis Island, where so many families of all origins arrived 100 years ago, hoping for liberty. And this is where both of us, Jews and Catholics, find ourselves side by side once more. Indeed, we can remember with emotion that the first major meeting between cardinals, archbishops, and Orthodox rabbis took place here on the initiative of Cardinal Jean-Marie Lustiger and Rabbi Israel Singer. This is why we have chosen this memorial to the Holocaust at the first stage of our visit to New York and more broadly to the United States. We want to express our appreciation of the decision to display for the first time in America the findings of the Ad Inundum organization after its researches on the extermination of Ukrainian Jews, what is called the Holocaust of bullets. And we wish to thank David Marwell for his courage, which made this exhibition possible. It is only justice to show the truth on the annihilation of East European Jews here in New York, where so many Jews from the former Soviet Union have found shelter and have managed to rebuild their families and communities. This exhibition allows the visitors to see and hear by themselves the evidence of the slaughter of Jews by the Einsatzgruppen, the violence after violence between 1941 and 1944. Let this be another opportunity to recall, whether the time is right or not, that being a Catholic is radically incompatible with denying the Holocaust, and that recent statements have caused suffering among our Jewish brothers and as well as among many Catholics. Here is New York. We are also meeting with our Orthodox Jewish brothers of Touro College, and we both look forward to the future and face together a major challenge. How can our traditions be transmitted in our universities? In this respect, I want to say how much we appreciate the presence with us of Dr. Bernard Lander, founder of Touro College. From Moscow to South Africa, he has created so many major institutions of higher education, which teach both the skills required in the modern world and the Jewish tradition in its toughness. How can we teach those who come to study in our schools about the Holocaust in depth and rigorously, according to the standards of historical criticism? We must realize that, unfortunately, the survivors are progressively disappearing. Reliable academic work on the Holocaust is required, as well as visits by young people to the extermination camps of Auschwitz and Birkenau, on the very location of those unspeakable crimes. This is the condition for the new generations to remember the men and women who were murdered all over Europe because they bore the holy names given by the Creator. This will also allow to breed watchmen who will, together on all five continents, keep on fighting against the emergence of genocides and mass violence, which are the lethal byproducts of one of man's most serious sins against God and humanity, I mean anti-Semitism and racism. We all know that sin will never die away, but we also know that the fight against it with God's help must consciously be not simply encouraged by thought as well. The stakes are no less than the lives of thousands and even millions of people worldwide. I thank you for your attention.